My name is Lily, and I have a disability called Friedreich's ataxia, which does affect my speech, as you've likely already noticed. Lately, I've been really inspired by YouTube creators who do outfit try-ons and go to the thrift store and just find ways to mix and match things in their closet. It's making me want to try a little more to come up with cool outfits. I actually had this video idea before I started watching those videos, but now I'm super duper inspired. I thought it would be fun to make a video about fashion tips for wheelchair users. And as it turns out, I have so many that I'm not going to be able to cover them all in one video. There are some that are more summery, warm weather. Right now, it's cool here. It's February. As you can see, it's a very overcast day. It is freezing cold outside and raining. Without too much further ado, I'm going to give you 5 sort of tips and tricks and advice points about things to do or not do if you're in a wheelchair that are more flattering to your body. At least I feel that these tips make my clothes more flattering to my body. I'm gonna wear a few different outfits in the video, and I think the funniest part is that in these other YouTube creator videos, they put on the outfit and they walk and strut and vogue and pose, and I'm in a wheelchair, so I'm like, this will be really funny to figure out. How can I pose in Vogue for a couple minutes to do a voiceover? Hope you enjoy the video, and please let me know in the comments what you think are some good fashion tips for wheelchair users. I am a statement earrings kind of girl, and I show you my earrings first on every outfit, then show you the whole outfit and my shoes. Definitely did not almost lose my balance for a second there, whoopsie. My first tip for wheelchair users is to bear in mind a lot of shirts that look good on able-bodied people bunch up weird at the bottom or leave a pool of fabric in your lap when you're sitting down all the time. My best way to counteract that is to tuck things in. Here you see I'm tucking in the under tank top to avoid unnecessary lumpiness, and you'll see in the third outfit that I tuck in a t-shirt. We got a light and dark contrast thing going on here with the jewelry, which I think is pretty cool. So we do want to avoid shirts that are long and loose, but the opposite end of that spectrum is shirts that are short and tight. Now, unfortunately, an inevitability of being a wheelchair user is the stomach pooch. And while I'm all about self-love and embracing your body, I don't want to emphasize my belly. Repeat after me, embrace, not emphasize. So second tip, tops that are cropped at the right length are great, but avoid crop tops that totally expose your belly, or generally shirts that hug your belly fat rolls. These outfits aren't really part of the video, I'm just adding this in the editing process because I feel I need to elaborate just slightly on my advice for tops. Number one, for shirts that are saggy but look weird tucked into the waist, such as this one, you can try tying it up. One might argue that tucking things into the waist actually emphasizes the wheelchair pooch, and I'm saying you don't. While it is more figure flattering to tuck in something, you'll want to pull the shirt out just a little so that it's not pulled completely taut. Girl, I love a pair of earrings that coordinates but doesn't match, and I love hairbands and hair bows. With this outfit, I want to make the point that wheelchair users should avoid shoes that are hard to put on or hard to transfer with. The shoes I'm wearing with this outfit are adorable and I love them, but I barely wear them because they're a pain in the neck to lace up. Also, I'm reiterating my first point by tucking in this t-shirt. You guys, kitty cats and teacups! My necklace has a lily flower. With this outfit, I want to talk about pants. Wheelchair users should gravitate to pants that are relatively easy to take on and off. And also bear in mind, when you're sitting down all day, your pants may need to be a bit longer than if you were able-bodied. And that especially applies to jolly gray giant queens like me with long grasshopper legs. These pants are technically yoga pants, and I just have to say, you really can dress up or dress down pants like this depending on the whole outfit. A turtleneck plus statement earrings plus hair up in a bun is a look. My fifth point is just to drive home the need to accessorize. Here I've got some blue in my headband and pink in my glasses, and blue and pink in my shoes to tie it all together. I just feel really chic in this outfit, even though I kinda messed up one side of my hair. Ignore that. Anyways, sometimes it feels hard to stand out in a wheelchair because you literally can't strut your stuff, but just put on all your glam and be your fabulous self, honey. Thanks for watching to the end of the video. Let me know in the comments if you liked my outfits or what you might do differently. And I hope to see you in the next one. Have a great day. Bye-bye.